Hello friends, we welcome you all to this video. In the previous video, we studied about the volume of a cuboid. Today, in this video, we will see some interesting examples based on that.
Thomas, do you know how important is air in life?
Yes, Manas. Air is a very important component for the survival of all species. Because in the air, we get oxygen.
Thomas, there is air in this room too. Can we guess how much air is present in this room?
Absolutely, Manas. We can find the answer through mathematics.
Oh, wow! That means it's math time!
You already know that the space taken by any object is called its volume. Because air is present inside this entire room, we can say that the air in the room will be equal to the volume of this room.
Look, Thomas, this room is in the shape of a cuboid. Do you remember the formula for finding the volume of a cuboid?
Of course, Manas. The volume of any cuboid is equal to the product of its length, width and height.
The length, width and height of the room are 12 feet, 10 feet and 8 feet respectively.
Friends, can you find the volume of this room? If you want, you can find the answer by stopping this video.
As we have written in our mathematics formula book, the volume of a cuboid is equal to the product of its length, width and height. Now, I just write the length of the room 12 feet, width 10 feet and height 8 feet respectively in the places of L, B and H.
Look, Manas, the volume of the room is 960 cubic feet. This means 960 cubic feet of air is present in this room.
Thomas, if there is so much air present in only one room, then imagine how much air will be present in this entire vast universe.
We might not even be able to count that much. Let us return to our world and go for a walk in the park in the open air.
Both friends went for a walk in the park. With the help of this example, we have seen how some problems in our daily life can be solved based on knowing how to find the volume of a cuboid. In the next video, we will see some more interesting examples based on this.